Okay, thank you for your questions. And now I invite you to do the yes and no exercise for the last 10, quarter of an hour with me and to deepen it and find out some more aspects of this exercise. And then we can afterwards still again listen to the resonance. What does this exercise do to us? So you remember, it's a left and right thing, and we just do it 5 times with the left foot. And you know all where the left foot is. It's there. Left foot. Yes. And back. And yes. Back. Yes. Back. Yes. Back. Yes. And back. Now I invite you to make a test. Wouldn't one normally say, yes, I want to have this? Yeah, yes, I agree. That's a direction forward. So it wouldn't it make more sense to just place the left leg a step forward? Please just make a straight step forward with the left foot. Yes, and stay stable. And come back. Again, we do it 5 times. Yes. And come back. Oh, just one more time. Yes. And come back. And now my question. How do you feel more stable if you do it straight or with the bow? So we do it the other 2 times straight now and afterwards 3 times with the bow. And just observe yourself, how do I feel more stable after I've arrived? 2 times straight. Yes. Firmly grounded. And yes. What's the feeling in your legs, in your body? And now with the bow to the left. Yes. And back. Again. Yes, and back, and again, yes, and back. Matthias, could you quickly put the bowl on the poll online? And would you mind to answer me which, then we can see it, who experienced which version more stable or the after arriving in front? You can still try, nobody sees it. And then give your answer, you can answer immediately. I'm very curious. So, after curve, we must see. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm getting advice. But I'm very excited. But nothing is wrong, huh? So, can you stop the poll, please? And the result you can all see is 85% or 83% feel more stable after curve. So that's not the other ones, they are not right. It's always what is for me easier, but isn't it a surprise? And I think when you do this yes and no exercise that you really feel the importance of the left and right, the plane of decision making. Do I go this way or do I go that way? Second aspect, which is important, so we have this plane left and right is important. Let's do the yes once again with the bow, yes. And now please feel in front of the plane you just stood in. And straight way back. Again, front, feel in front, and back. In front, yes. Fourth time, yes. And in front, yes. and back. And do the same with the no and the right leg when you go back. No, and feel behind. Remember this plane where you stood in. And now stand in the plane again. Big bow to the left, the right. Arrive on both feet. And no. No. Remember the plane in front. How does it feel to be behind? And good. And that's the preparation. You really bring your body into this experience from being in front. You really bring it into the experience of being behind. And now we start a rhythm between those. So we do left, forward, yes, and back, no, and yes, and no, and yes, and no, and yes, and no, and yes, and no, and come back. I think we all of us, yeah, we face this left and right, we were in front, we were in back, in the back. But did you remember what I said in the beginning, the yes and no exercise takes place here. From here, I move my leg around to the front. From here, I move my other one back. And here, I feel myself in the front and in the back. Now let's try to move the leg from with our heart and lung forces. Become broad here and move in front. And then go back, and now like this. And now always try to feel it here. It's a bow in front, it continues, it's a bow, yeah, and you feel it flowing around your heart. Move with your heart, the legs, and let your heart be moved by the legs. And stop. Can you feel that's not just an eight and lemniscate you're moving in? Because you're going on the left side forward, then a little bit straight back, but it's not going continuing on the left side on the other side, but it's again the right. It's a little bit like in the heart. Everything, it comes in, it gets chaos, it's a new bow. Just feel this continuous flow and the contradictions which take place there. It's a flow, counterflows, and so on. Let's do it again, and now let's become bigger, quicker. And let's try that we not get fixed on our feet, but we still, despite everything gets quicker, we do the movement from out our heart. And now we do it 10 times. Forward, backward, from the heart. We start slow, we become bigger. Yes, and no, and yes, and no, and yes, and no, and yes, and no. And yes, and no, and yes, and no. And yes, and no. Did you manage to stay here? And still get it down to the ground. And there's no criticism necessary. The important thing only is that you tried to do it like that. Please sit down for a short moment and listen to the resonance. How do my legs feel? My chest, is it? How does it react? Does my chest like what we have done? How does it express that it likes it? What about my spine and my shoulder blades? Do I feel them? Is my left and my right shoulder blade equal in my perception? What does my belly say in relation to my lungs? Which part feels bigger? Which one smaller? Questions like this. Do you experience colors, pictures? Does it generate moods? Or thoughts? Thoughts maybe which do not come out of the head, but from somewhere else. Things like that. Everything can be observed. There will be a webinar by me where I explain the exercises from Rudolf Steiner from overcoming nervousness, which can be very helpful. Everyday exercises you can do every day and which strengthens your etheric body, your astral body, and in many, many ways the ego willpower in you, things which are needed in these times too. So if you are interested, just drop by. The webinar is for free and there's no donation requested. It's just because maybe I find some people who want to do a guided course afterwards with me, and then we go through these exercises step by step for about 8-9 weeks. I wish you a good time. See you. And if you like it, tell it others. They are invited too. Bye-bye.